Can God ransom back a life? Can he ransom back a marriage? Can he ransom back our children? Can he ransom back our past, our present, our future, our hopes, our dreams? I love what David says in Psalm 68:20. He says, our God is a God who saves. And I grew up the son of an evangelist, Pat Preacher, and in Sunday school, I probably heard the phrase, Jesus is my Savior, more times than I can count. But the phrase was like bones without flesh. It just never took on meaning. It never sunk in. It was just a phrase. And my father and I, we had a rough relationship. It wasn't great. And in my teenage years, when I was 13, I started down a path of alcohol and drug addiction. And from when I was 13 on to my early 20s, it was dark. It was heavy substance abuse. In the last 5 years of this very dark chapter, I was a crystal meth addict. And every day for those 5 years, I was using crystal meth. And at one point, you know, I was just thinking, it got so bad that I knew that this is how I would die. And I remember the scary part about it was I was okay with it, because I couldn't imagine ever being able to be free from the hold of the spiral that had become my life. But I didn't know that I was about to encounter the God that saves. So, it's good. He is who he says he is. And so, let me just capture a moment for you. It's my story, but it's all of our stories. So imagine a room. It's dark. It's empty. Your thoughts are almost deafening with phrases like, there's no hope. This situation is too far gone. It's too late. This is unredeemable. You are unredeemable. And then a voice whispers, and it's familiar, but yet frightening. And this voice whispers some words, a phrase that topples every tower of despair, of shame, of pain, of hurt, with one phrase. As he begins to say these words to you, this all crumbles. He says, I am the God that saves. From ashes I ransom. From rubble I rebuild, I restore, I revive, I redeem, I renew. I'm revealing myself to you. Do you want to know me? And like many saints before us, we tremble in the presence of this God. That says these words. And we say, God, I want to know you. I don't know how to let go of all this. I don't know how to be anything else. I don't know how to let go of the hurt, the hopelessness, the destruction. This situation is gone. It's too much, Lord. I don't know how to let go of this life, this world that I've let surround me like a lifeless tomb, Lord. I don't know how to do it. And then the voice that spoke stars and mountains and all things into being says, you don't have to, because I will. Do you believe that I am who I said I am? Do you believe I am the God that saves? And as you agree with his nature and how he's revealed himself to you, like the sun piercing through the trees after a storm, you see with new eyes the one who is beautiful and powerful and has always been there. And now that thing that seems immeasurable and overwhelming to get past seems so small in his greatness. And I encountered this God and I know him intimately. This same God said to me, I transform meth addicts into worship leaders. Right? Good. So good. And this same God is revealing himself to everyone in this room right now. He says, I am the God that saves. Do you want to know me? I am the Zephaniah 3:17 God. I am mighty to save. Right? I delight in you. I will quiet you with my love. I will sing over you. It's like a father who has found his long-lost child. This God is revealing himself to us in this room. And he's saying to you right now, lean in. And if you listen carefully, you will hear me sing over you a song of redemption, a song that quiets all the raging rivers, a song of salvation, a song of victory. And God, we love you because you are the God that saves, and you don't stop there. It's not just the moment of salvation, Lord. You redeem the broken marriages. You save us from the situations that we think are hopeless, God. You are ever faithful at this, Lord.
Trying to speak to us, and we want to hear. You are a father that loves his children. And there is a father. You've seen this picture of the prodigal son returning to the father. And the father running to embrace the son. And even in his brokenness and his weakness and his desire maybe just to come back as a servant, he's embraced as a son. That the God that saves doesn't save us to servitude. He saves us to sonship. He redeems us and puts shoes on our feet and clothes on our back and rings on our fingers. He redeems us to a great position of sonship. And God, we're here tonight to say we are your sons and your daughters. That you've saved us. You've redeemed us from the grave. We are your sons. We are your daughters. We are the redeemed. Let the God.